Just a baby boy, my happy heart would jump for joy when daddy'd take me to the general store. There was everything that you could name, from carpet tacks to window paint and lazy handles laying round the door. There were garden hose and axe handles and breadboards and wax candles and curtain rods and mats made out of twine. There was ink and onion and navy beans and tins of coffee, brown and green, and everything from silk to gingham's fine. Well, one summer's day I chanced to spy a cookie tin away up high upon a shelf inside the general store. Well, I started up to fetch a prize when the walls started to capsize and tumbled with a crash to the floor. There were shoes and books and pots and pans and fine combs and garbage cans and broken jars all piled around my head. There were caps and boots and black molasses and young seeds for garden grasses and pies and cookies, cakes and loaves of bread. Well, when daddy grabbed me by the arm and took me back out to the farm, I couldn't sit down for a week or more. But the years have passed with no regrets, and I know I never will forget that place we fondly call the general store. There were thread and nutmeg, pins and powder, rat poison and clam chowder, and garden tools all littering up the floor. There was cranberries and clocks and clippers and ringers, rakes and carpet slippers and apple peelers you don't see no more. In that great forgotten wonderland, I visited with my old man the great and unforgettable general store.